This is another small lesson on Maheshwara Sutras. Now, these recognizable sounds, who recognized it first? How was it captured from the universe? We said that there are sounds which were produced from the universe, and these sounds were captured in the form of Vedic sounds by the rishis who were in deep tapas. These rishis or sages had deep yogic powers to discern these syllables and sounds. Now, our grammarian Panini also had this experience. Let us understand this in this chapter. At the end of this lesson, we will be covering what are the Maheshwara Sutras, know the meaning of a term called Pratyahara, the importance of the Maheshwara Sutras for language. These are the three main things that we'll be studying. Very rarely we get stories in a grammar class. Here we have a story. Let us understand what the story is. There was this Maharishi Panini who did penance, Tapaha Chakara. Paninihi Vyakaranam Gratitum Utsukaha, Tapaha Chakara. He did penance. From the result of the penance was that Parameshwara, Lord Maheshwara, he did a Tandava Nritya, and through the Damaru, he produced sounds. Shankaraha Dakkam Chaturdashavaram Nanada. So what did Shankara or Maheshwara do was, he used the Damaru, the handheld drum, and 14 times he created sounds. He used the drum and created 14 sounds. This was discerned or experienced by Panini Maharishi, and there were other Maharishis also, Sanakadi Siddhas, who also used the same sounds to understand Parama Vedanta Tattva. Panini Maharishi, through the help of these sounds, could decide and formulate a structure of how he has to build the structure of the Vyakarana Sutras, the rules of grammar. These rules are concised into a grantha called Ashtadhyayi, which has 8 chapters, each chapter having 4 padas. Padas refer to 4 sub-chapters, you can call it. So 32 sub-chapters. He composed 3,984 sutras, rules for Sanskrit grammar. And that could be possible from the base of these sutras, these 3,984 sutras, are the 14 Maheshwara sutras, which came from the Damaru of Lord Parameshwara. This is how the story goes. Even if there are some people who argue that it is not Maheshwara, Panini himself did this. But this is an interesting story also, we can learn. These sutras which came from the Maheshwara's Damaru are called as Maheshwara Sutras. Now, what are these 14 rules? What do they tell? And how? Where is the pramana for all this? There is a shloka which is taken as the pramana. Dritta vasane nataraja rajo nanada dhakkam navapanchavaram uddhartu kamaha sanakadi siddhan yetad vimarshe shivasutra jalam. Dritta vasane nataraja rajo. Lord Nataraja, at the end of his cosmic dance, sounded his drum, handheld drum, 14 times. Desiring to bless the sages, I shall interpret these 14 sutras of Shiva. That is how this meaning of this shloka goes. Now, what does, finally, we have to come to the essence of the Maheshwara Sutras. What do these Maheshwara Sutra contain? What are these? It is just the Akshara Samamnaya or the alphabets listed in a different way, which are actually called as Maheshwara Sutras. What is the different way, sir? How are these alphabets represented? First, let us see the Maheshwara Sutras coming out of the Damaru of Shiva. Okay. I will teach these sutras I would request Megha to repeat only once, and others can also repeat.
Ayun.
Rilruk.
Rilruk.
Aong.
Aong.
I out. Hayavarat.
Hayavarat.
Learn.
Learn.
Nyamagananam.
Nyamagananam.
Jabhang.
Jabhang.
Ghadhadash. Jabagadash.
Jabagadash.
Kapha chatata chatatav.
Kapha chatata chatatav.
Kapai.
Kapai.
Shashasar.
Shashasar.
Hal.
Hal.
These are the 14 Maheshwara Sutras. The order is very important. You can't change the order. Why we can't change the order, we will see in a minute.